Welcome students, myself Dr. Biswamar Mohanty. In the last part of the video, we have discussed non-mechanical loop, mechanical loop and transverse and longitudinal wave. Today we shall discuss the relation between the velocity wave, frequency and wavelength. So this is the wave. Most important point in the last class, last video, we have discussed the particles medium makes to and fro motion about the mean person when the wave propagates in the forward direction. The particles medium not moving along with the wave, only they are vibrating about the mean person. So this is the length of a wave. Wavelength is the length of a wave or the distance between the crest or tops. This is the one wave, length of a wave, wavelength, length of wave. This is one wave. This is one wave, this is the wavelength, and this is also a one wave. So the length of wave is lambda. This is the one wave lambda. So you can write it as lambda. The velocity wave is a constant. The velocity wave per particular medium is constant, the velocity particle is variable. As the particle execute a system, the particle velocity variable but the velocity wave is constant. So the velocity wave is the time period T. This is the time period. This is the time taken for one complete address oscillation. The distance travelled by the wave is lambda. When the particle makes one complete oscillation during that time, the wave distance travelled by the wave is lambda. So velocity v is equal to, this is the velocity wave. Velocity wave in a particular medium is constant, but the particle velocity is variable. Then the velocity of wave in a particular medium, the velocity wave is constant. So this is the velocity wave. This is the wavelength lambda by T. This is the length of wave. This is the wavelength. And this is the time period. And 1 by frequency is equal to 1 by time period. Reciprocal of the time period is called the frequency wave. So this is V is equal to 1 by time period lambda. 1 by T is equal to F into lambda. So this is the velocity wave. This is the frequency of wave. This is the wavelength of the wave. So velocity wave is constant, but the particle velocity is variable. So now we can calculate also the relation between the angular frequency and propagation constant. What is propagation? Wave propagation constant K is equal to 2 pi by lambda is called as the wave propagation constant. So omega is equal to 2 pi by T, or that is equal to 2 pi into F. Whether that F is equal to V by lambda. So we can write it as 2 pi F is equal to V by lambda. And 2 pi by lambda is equal to wave propagation constant. This omega is equal to V into K. This is the another relation, this is the angular frequency. This is the velocity wave. This is the wave propagation constant. This is the angular frequency, velocity wave and wave propagation constant, omega is equal to vk. Omega is equal to vk. Omega angular frequency, this is the velocity of k, is the wave propagation constant. Now what is the equation of progressive wave? equation of progressive wave is y is equal to a sine. Okay, we will discuss the equation of progressive wave. The equation of progressive wave is y is equal to a sine kx plus minus omega t. Negative sign, when the wave propagates in the positive x-axis direction, and positive sign, when the wave propagates in the negative x-axis direction. Or it can be expressed as y is equal to a cos kx minus omega t. Similarly, negative sign indicates that when the wave propagates in the positive x direction, and positive sign indicates that when the wave propagates in the negative x-axis direction. So, equation of progressive wave can be expressed in terms of sine or cosine. Now, what is y? Suppose I am taking one example equation of progressive wave, I am taking the either sine or cos wave, I am taking just a sine equations. Suppose this is y is equal to a sine kx minus omega t. That means wave propagates in the positive x-axis direction. So yxt means that the y is equal to sine xt means this is the yxt. So yxt means yxt is equal to a sine kx minus omega t. Or it can be expressed as y is equal to a sine 2 pi by lambda x minus 2 pi by capital T into small t. We may express as yxt. Or we can write it as y is equal to a sine 2 pi by 2 pi into x by lambda minus small t by capital T. Or we may express as y is equal to sine 2 pi by lambda x minus 2 pi by 2 pi by lambda 2 pi by lambda into t. Lambda by capital T to small t. So y is equal to a sine kx minus omega t, or yxt is equal to a sine 2 pi by lambda minus 2 pi by capital T to small t, or yxt is equal to a sine 2 pi into x by lambda minus small t by capital T. So these are the form of the equation of progressive wave. These are the form of the equation. What is y? Y is the displacement of the particle at any instant of time t. What is x? X is the distance traveled by the wave when the displacement having at any time, when the displacement y, x is the distance traveled by the wave at time t second. And lambda is the wavelength of the wave, and capital T is the time period, and small t at any instant of time t second the displacement of y. Y is the displacement of the particle at any time t second, and x is the distance traveled by the wave, and a is the amplitude. I is the amplitude of wave. Maximum displacement is the amplitude. A maximum displacement of the particle is the amplitude. This is the amplitude wave. Y is the displacement particle, x the distance traveled by the wave at any time t second, lambda is the wavelength, and capital is the time period, capital T. Now we will discuss the relation between the particle velocity and wave velocity. We know that yxt is equal to a sine kx minus omega t. Y is the displacement of the particle at any instant of time t second. A is the amplitude wave, k is the propagation constant, omega is the angular frequency. So velocity of the particle means that is equal to dy by dt. So dy by dt is equal to a cos kx minus omega t minus omega. So that is the velocity of the particle. Dp is the velocity of the particle. Is equal to a minus a omega cos kx minus omega t. This is the velocity of the particle. And acceleration of the particle is equal to the next is the slope. Suppose you take that example, you take the slope of wave. So dy by dx is equal to dy by dx is equal to derivative dy by dx of a sin kx minus omega t. Then we can write it as dy by dx is equal to slope a k cos kx minus omega t. This is the slope of y plus x graph. Slope of the wave of y plus x graph dividing. So velocity particle dy by dx the slope dividing. This is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Dividing equation 1 and 2 minus a omega cos kx minus omega t divided by a k cos kx minus omega t. A cancel. You know that. So cos kx minus omega t cancel. So velocity particles is equal to minus omega by k into dy by dx. Since you know that omega is equal to vk, omega by k is equal to v is the velocity wave. So velocity particle is equal to minus v into slope. This is the velocity, v is the velocity wave into slope. So this is the velocity of the particle. This is the velocity of wave. This is the slope. This is the relation between the velocity particle, velocity wave and slope. Then what is the how to calculate the acceleration particle? So taking the derivative of the velocity, we can calculate the acceleration particle from equation 1. From equation 1, we know that the velocity particle minus a omega cos kx minus omega t. So acceleration particle from equation 1. Acceleration particle is equal to dv by dt. So that is why that is a derivative of d by dt of minus a omega cos kx minus omega t, partial derivative. So f is equal to minus a omega minus omega minus sine kx minus omega t. You know that f is equal to minus minus plus minus minus omega square a sine kx minus omega t. And you know that y is equal to a sine kx minus omega t. This is the displacement equals to displacement progressive wave. Why is the displacement particle? So this is the displacement of the particle. So acceleration particle we can write it as. So acceleration of the particle, we know that found to be AP is found to be AP is equal to minus omega square into y, which proves that whenever the wave propagates in the horizontal direction, the particle makes SHM about the mean position. Actually, it has been derived from the equation of wave. Acceleration of particle is equal to minus omega square y, which is the condition of SHM for a particle executing SHM. So it has been concluded that from the equation wave, when the wave propagates, I have already given the information that when the wave propagates in the forward direction, the particle of the medium makes to and fro motion about the mean position. All it has been proved. AP is equal to acceleration of particle is equal to minus omega square y. Is the axis of particle, y is the displacement particle. So when the wave propagates, the particle medium are not moving along the wave, only they are vibrating about their mean position, executing shifted harmonic motion. As a result, energy or momentum transfer from one particle to next particle. Now we will discuss some problems basing upon these theories. Number one problem is that find out the direction and direction of velocity and acceleration from point 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the equation of, this is the graph of y, equation of wave. Graph of a wave. See, this is the wave, graph of wave. So find out that this snapshot is taken. I have taken the snapshot of wave. Find out the direction and the velocity, direction of velocity and acceleration of the particle at 1, 2, 3, 4. So, in this case, what is the direction of velocity at this point, at one point? Velocity and acceleration at one point. At point 1, you just take the velocity, Vb is equal to velocity of the particle minus b into slope. This is the most important relation. First you take, at point 1 take the slope. Slope is positive. At point 1 slope is positive. And since the wave is propagating the forward positive x-axis, so v is positive. So velocity particle is, this is negative. As the wave is propagating the positive x-axis, this is the velocity wave in the positive direction, x-axis direction, and slope is positive. So positive, positive, negative. So multiplying this, this is negative. That means velocity particle is downright. That is the velocity particle is downright. Regarding the axis of particle, our AP is equal to, already given the information, AP is equal to minus omega square y. As the y is positive, as the y is positive, minus omega, this is negative, and y is positive, at point 1 we have to calculate the axis of particle, whether upward or downright. As the y is positive, so this is positive, so that is why it is negative, so this is downright. So axis of particle is downright. At point 2. At point 2. At point 2. See, I take the slope. At point this slope is 0. At point 2 this slope is 0. Slope is 0, velocity particle is equal to minus b into slope. So since slope is 0, so velocity particle is 0. So axis of particle is a is equal to minus omega square y. So this is negative. So y is positive. So is positive. So this is negative. So axis is downright. So at point 2, velocity is 0 as the slope is 0. Acceleration is downwards. At point 3, at point 3 take the slope. At point 3 slope is negative. So velocity particle, velocity minus v into slope. So this is negative. Velocity wave is propagating in the positive x-axis direction, that is why it is positive. Slope is negative, so that is negative, negative, positive. So velocity particle is upward. Velocity particle is upward. At point 3 is velocity particle is upward. And axis of particle, a is equal to minus omega square y. So axis of particle is minus negative, y is positive, y is positive. So that is why negative. This is downward. So at point 3, the axis of particle is downward. At point 4, at point 4, so at point 4, you just take the slope. At point 4, slope is 0. So velocity particle is minus b into slope. So minus b into the velocity wave is positive but slope is zero. That is why velocity particle at point p is zero. As the axle and displacement is negative at 4, the displacement y is negative. The acceleration particle is minus omega square into I minus this is negative. So negative, negative, positive, this is upward. So acceleration particle is upward. So at point 4, the acceleration particle is upward and the velocity particle is 0. So this is the regarding the direction of velocity and acceleration at different points on the, if a snapshot is taken from a wave, so direction of velocity and acceleration can be calculated by the following technique. We are adopting this technique to calculate the direction of velocity and acceleration of the particle in a, if a snapshot is taken from a wave. Next is the number 2 question. We'll discuss the very most important question. A transverse wave moves along a stream in the positive x-axis direction. This the wave is and a string moving along the positive x direction as shown in figure. At a speed 10 meter per second, this is the velocity wave is 10 meter per second, and wavelength of the wave is 0.5. The lambda is equal to 0.5 meter or 50 centimeter. And amplitude of is 10, so this is the maximum displacement is amplitude is 10 centimeter. This is the amplitude is 10 centimeter. At a particular time t, the snapshot of the wave is shown in figure. The velocity of the point P, point means the particle of the point P. Point means the particle of the point P, this is the position of the particle in shoot SH. So the velocity of the point P means the particle of the point P. When the displacement is 5 cm, when the displacement is 5 cm, what is the velocity of the point P? We have to, what is our aim? Aim is to calculate the velocity of the point P. Every particle will exhibit SH. We have to calculate the velocity of the particle of the point P. Point P is the particle. We have to calculate the velocity of the particle. We know that whenever the particle executes SHL, the equation velocity of the particle V is equal to either V P is equal to V velocity particle omega into A square minus Y square or R square minus Y square. I had given omega is equal to V velocity particle omega into R square minus Y. R square means amplitude. In this case, Y amplitude is A. R means is the amplitude, SH. A square minus Y square. So omega is equal to 2 pi by 2 pi b, 2 pi by 5. So lambda is equal to, that is equal to 50 centimeter, that 2 pi by 5, that is 10 square, is the amplitude of SH is equal to 10 centimeter, 10 square minus 5 plus, this is equal to velocity particle 2 pi root 3 centimeter per second. But option is given meter per second, that is why you have to convert to meter per second. That is equal to by 100 dividing 100, that is equal to root 3 pi by 50 meter per second. Most important part is direction. And there are four choices there. So root 3 pi 50 meter per second, that is root 3 pi 50 meter per second. Root 3 pi by 50 meter per second, that is upward. I cap or J cap, both are given, both options are given. So how to calculate the direction of particle? By applying this technique, V is equal to velocity particles minus b into slope. See, the wave is propagating the positive x-axis direction. The direction velocity wave is positive. This is negative. And at point P, the slope at point P, the slope is negative. At point P, the slope is negative. That is why negative, negative, positive, negative, this is positive. So that is why. So velocity of particle is equal to positive. Positive means positive y-axis. So the particle is vibrating along y-axis. So that is why root 3 pi by 50 I cap meter per second. So among the four options, root 3 pi by J cap, root 3 pi I cap, that is the answer is root 3 pi, sorry, this is J cap meter per second. So root 3 pi by 50 J cap meter per second. This is root 3 pi by 50 J cap meter per second. Thank you very much.